Today, when I was at that place where I got, if you saw the previous video, or maybe two previous, depending on now, whenever this goes up, I got Sonic 3 for the Genesis Mega Drive, and also got the Mega Mouse, Sega Mega Mouse for it. When I went there to that place, and he's got a few of those in the store, not many, it all depends when you go, obviously they sell out or wherever. There's a few reproduction cartridges in there, and then that got me thinking a few hours later. I've actually, of all the videos I've done, not one time have I made a video, short, long, whatever it might be, talking about reproduction cartridges. So guess what? I'm going to do that now, as you can tell by the title. I really don't have much to say about it because there's just not much to say about it. I've seen a few people talk about this, and I'm pretty much with them, you know. It's a good thing. That's all there is to it, if you wanted just to know right away what I think. I think it's a good thing. I got really no problem with it. That said, though, I really am not interested in pretty much any of them, except for one I have seen, which was at this place. And I'll use this as an example as to why. It's a game for the Genesis, but it was never released in North America for the Genesis, which, of course, as you might know, it's only called the Genesis here. You know, North American and PAL systems run at different rates and all that. You can't really put a PAL game into a North American Genesis. Especially if it was made after the region lockout, which I made a video a while ago talking about that, a long while ago. But anyway, you cannot play Mega Man Wily Wars in a North American Genesis. You can't. It was never released in North America for whatever reason. It wasn't even released in Japan, which is weird. It was only released in PAL territories, you know, which, you know, I mean, like Europe. So there's that. But because they made a reproduction cartridge of this, which was very well done, by the way. The label, the box was just like a, you know, Genesis game, like I'm holding here. It had the insert on it, which looked professional again. It had the red stripe like it's supposed to here. And it also had a manual, which, again, was made very professional. It didn't have any color, but, you know, I'm not going to fault it for that because it had everything else there. They pretty much recreated the manual that's in the actual Wily Wars game. They just changed it to say Genesis on it and all that, and, you know, the fit with the North American version, but whatever. And you can play it in the North American system. That one I'd probably get. It was too much at the time. It was $59.99, and I really didn't want to spend that much on one game like that, especially when, at the time, I wasn't really completely sure what it was. And then I ended up going back a few days later, and I brought it up again, and that's when they explained it to me. But that's the only one, really, I've seen that I'd personally go for, but I have seen many others. I mean, there's ones for hack games, there's ones for games that never came out. For example, I know of one for the NES, it's called Drax Night Out. That game was never released anywhere, so you get to play it for a reproduction cartridge, you know what I mean? There's other ones, like there's, I wouldn't say altered, but different versions of Zelda games, like Link to the Past, there's, I guess you could call them hacked versions, and you can get those on reproduction cartridges. There's also this pretty rare one called Zelda BD, or is it BG? I can't remember which one it is. It's one of those two. And I think it's like a bunch of the best dungeons mixed together, or it's remixed versions of dungeons or something. I'm not really 100% sure. But there's that. You can get it on a reproduction cartridge, and there's fan translations of certain other games that were only released in Japan. You know, there's those. I've heard of one for Secret of Mana 2. In fact, I think I saw someone's video who has it. But on here, I'm not entirely sure, so I can't tell you who it was. Sorry. But you get my point, what I'm trying to say, right? It's interesting you can play games that were never released at all, or in a case like Mega Man Wily Wars, one that was only released in Europe, or ones that were never in English, they were only in Japanese. You know, stuff like that. I find it's very interesting. It's good. They're not really cheap, but I understand why they're not, and I don't have a problem with that, but, you know, I just think they're interesting. I like them, I have nothing against them, and I'm glad that they do make stuff like this, because, you know, you get to play this kind of stuff that you really would not be able to otherwise. I find it's good, I like it, and the effort I've seen put into these ones I've seen in person, and in pictures and video and all that, I gotta say, I really do like the amount of dedication and effort they put into these things, because they make them really do look like they're an official game that came out, you know, by Sega or whoever it was. It's really cool. I like it. As I said, Wily Wars is probably the one I'd get if I could, but whatever. That's probably not possible now for me. It's long gone. Not in that store anymore. But anyway, that's all I wanted to talk about, reproduction cartridges. Went a little longer than I wanted to, but oh well, kind of repeated a few things. It happens. So that's it. I just wanted to make this little thing, talk about what I think about them. I really haven't mentioned anything about them up to this point, but now I have. So that's it. Thanks for watching and listening. And as always, say what you think about the whole deal. And if you do have any reproduction cartridges, what ones are those? And why'd you get them? All that. You can figure that out. So that's it. And I will see you next time.